Good afternoon, everyone. Pastor Scott at Gloria Day Lutheran Church in Tomah, Wisconsin. And I'd like to share a little devotion to you with you today. The scripture that I would like to base it after is actually 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7, that basically teaches us that we ought to cast our cares upon God. The English Standard Version says this: casting all your anxieties on Him because He cares for you. Now, it's amazing with the things that are going on right now in our nation. This is a perfect verse to be talking about because so many of us are anxious. We're anxious about the health of our nation. You know, the divisions that are happening right now, certainly big political divisions going on, but also divisions with people and what their thoughts are towards this COVID-19. And whether people are very concerned or those who are not concerned at all, and divisions with how are we going to open up schools and what are we going to do with our kids and our children, and the stresses that this brings to not only families but to couples, and with all of this going on, how are we dealing with it? How are we moving forward in our lives, and where are we casting our anxieties? Now, of course, the word cast means to throw forcibly. And I think about casting with fishing. And I don't do all that much fishing anymore, but I do remember when I was young and I would go fishing with my friends up in north central Wisconsin, and we'd head down to the Wisconsin River or out to one of the lakes. And it wasn't always that we were so concerned about catching fish. I mean, that was a big part of it. But we'd like to get into little competitions with each other. And often what we would do is we'd see who could cast our lure out the furthest and get it way out there. And so we would take our rod and reel, and we'd try to time it just right, and we'd cast those lines out there and see who could supposedly get it out the farthest. And that's what Jesus is really talking about here. That's what scripture is saying. It implies more than just a casual placing of our concerns at Jesus' feet. No, you are forcibly, you are really reaching out to God in prayer, in word, and casting our cares upon God. And what is that going to do? Well, it's going to give us a picture of maybe the way in which we should go in our lives. Because we need to trust. We need to trust God, who loves us and who cares for us. And we need to trust that He can catch all of those concerns, and that He's going to know exactly how to deal with all of that and help us get through. Now, I also must be consistent, and I must be deliberate about noticing the little things that concern me. The fact is so often we'll just set things aside in our lives, and we need to realize that if there is something that is concerning us, something that is troubling us, an anxiety, something, and it may be with our health, it may be with our finances, it may be with our relationships with others, our families, our friends, or it may also be the concerns and anxieties that we see on television every single day. But we need to take those concerns and we need to lay them at the feet of Jesus. And how do we do that? We do it in prayer. We do it in talking. We've got to talk to Jesus. We've got to talk to God about those things, whether it's verbally or by jotting them down, maybe in a journal if you like to journal things. However you like to symbolize, you know, giving those things to Jesus. But to cast or throw them with all of your might. Now, don't just be casual about it. Just really do it. Pray with faith, believing that God does care and that He is fully capable of handling all of your requests. Because I know He is. I believe that Jesus is. You know, will the cares and concerns of this life keep cropping up over and over again? Boy, you know, sadly, I have to say yes to that, because After all of these years being here, they do. They just keep propping up day after day. And yeah, you'll have those good days going in a row, and we thank God and for those blessings that happen. But most certainly, life is a challenge. And we live in this sinful, fallen world, and there are so many concerns and anxieties. But let me reassure you that as you consistently and deliberately cast your cares on Him, you're going to begin to see how far anxiety and fear and stress and worry all just move away from you as you continue to grow in your faith and learn to trust in the God who loves you so much. From Paul's letter to the Philippians 4, verses 6 through 7, it says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God." And then what's going to happen? Well, it goes on. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, is going to guard your hearts and your minds. And it's all through Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior. So let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, so much of our lives seem broken, and the anxieties and the stress that continue to keep cropping up in our lives, it just at times it seems never ending. We have so many concerns and cares that they weigh us down. So help me to desire and to want to just cast all of my cares upon you, Lord. I find I usually pick them back up again, and they add more anxiety and stress if I just, keep going back to them. But Lord, I know that you and only you can help me learn to cast all of my cares to you. So Lord, help me do that. Give me strength to get through each and every day. And I pray for those who are hurting so badly during these times of stress and anxiety. Lord, help our nation to be one again, and to be one in you, trusting in all that you are, your truth. In Jesus' name, amen. So take care today. Stay healthy. Get outside. Enjoy the beautiful sun. I don't know if you're up in my area of the country, but certainly in Wisconsin, we're enjoying some beautiful weather right now. And it is so healthy for each and every one of us to get outside and to enjoy and to breathe in all of God's creation. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye-bye.